One out of 10 Americans have a sex addiction. And sex addiction is defined by having a compulsive urge or craving to act out in certain sexual behaviors repeatedly. And in spite of the fact that the result is always the same, shame and guilt and self-loathing and self-hatred, and getting the feeling of desperation, that craving and that urge continues over and over again. And the person who has this sex addiction will continue to act out in sexual behaviors that repeatedly makes them feel inferior, filled with shame and guilt and self-loathing. And in essence, walking around in life, living in somewhat of a fantasy world, wearing masks because they are hiding who they are as a person. And most sex addicts live in shame and live in secrecy. So to escape the grip of sex addiction, there are many strategies that you would need to master to ultimately live a life free of sex addiction. And it is possible for you. I am recovering from sex addiction. My spiritual advisor said that I was one of the worst cases of sex addiction he has ever experienced. And I now have 11 years free from that grip, that horrific grip of active sex addiction. The sex addicted mind will be with me for the rest of my life. But as I master strategies living a life of sexual sobriety, it gets easier and easier and easier to live life free from active sex addiction. And that's my mission for you. My mission for you is to break free from active sex addiction and live your life so you can be happy and joyous and free. So that's what I want for you. And fortunately, I have experienced the transition from decades of sex addiction to now nearly 11 or actually over 11 years free from active sex addiction. And believe me, if it's possible for me to be sober and clean from drugs and alcohol and sex addiction, it's possible for you too. So with one out of 10 Americans battling with sex addiction, this is obviously common, and it's not something that a lot of people like to talk about. But what we want to do is we don't want to necessarily just address sex addiction. We want to address sex addiction sobriety. We want to address how to break free from this horrific addiction and live a life of sexual sobriety. So I do want to offer you three suggestions that you have right now available when it comes to your sex addiction. Well, one, you can remain sex addicted for the rest of your life. You can live a life addicted to sexual behaviors and live a life filled with shame and guilt and feeling inferior and walking around with masks and not being a spiritually free, happy, peaceful, serene person. And you can live the rest of your life warped and wrapped in the grips of sex addiction. Sex addiction ripples out into so many areas of your life. It inhibits success and prosperity. It inhibits truly an authentic, loving relationship. It inhibits your prospering professionally. It inhibits your income potential because you're not focused. You're not giving life your all because the sex addiction is so draining, and it pretty much acts as though a vampire of life, and it pulls and sucks the life out of you, your active sex addiction. Because of that sex addiction, you're not having a successful, sustainable, loyal relationship. You're not fulfilling your potential professionally. You're certainly not reaching your potential income for a life of financial prosperity because you're so drained, so tired, so exhausted. It's taking away from your sleep patterns. It's taking away from your focus during the day, and it's taking away from your potential. So if you want to settle for a life of mediocrity or less, feel free to stay in the grip of your active sex addiction. That is certainly one option for you. Another option for you is to break free from your sex addiction, and there's two ways you can do that. One way you can break free from sex addiction is taking a look at all of your sexually addictive behaviors. Take a look at all the behaviors you're sexually addicted to. Because although you may be a sex addict, you're not addicted to simply sex. You're addicted to certain behaviors that give you that fix that you have become so accustomed to in your life. Now, there's many reasons behind why you have those sex addictive behaviors, what those behaviors are giving you, because those sexually addictive behaviors give you a payoff. You get a payoff from it. Feeling good, feeling high, feeling needed, wanted, desired, feeling sexy, feeling nurtured on some level, feeling cared for, feeling wanted. So there is a payoff that you're getting from those sexually addictive behaviors. Later on, once you experience sexual sobriety, you're going to want to feel all those things: being loved, nurtured, wanted, needed, desired. You're going to want to feel all those things, but through healthy behaviors, and feel those things. But because you're a sex addict, you feel those things, or at least the illusion that you feel those things from these sexually addictive behaviors. And that's why those behaviors are so compelling in your life. Your brain is also a drug manufacturing machine. So those behaviors are releasing opiates and dopamine from your brain into your body, making you feel high. So you're, on some degree, you are drug addicted to the brain chemicals. So your brain has become a drug manufacturing machine. But those sexually addictive behaviors is what you need to look at. So as a sex addict, what sexually addictive behaviors are you addicted to? So there's two ways to experience sobriety once you take a look at those sexually addictive behaviors. One, you can go cold turkey and you can eliminate all those sexually addictive behaviors out of your life immediately. Stop all of those addictive behaviors and focus on sobriety, but you need help to do that. Trust me, you're not going to be able to do it alone. You need help. You need either a program or a course or a coaching program or a 12-step or a spiritual advisor. You need something, someone, a group, some support and encouragement to keep you focused, to keep your eyes on the prize. So doing it alone won't work. It'll be futile. You'll continue to go back to those behaviors. And if you're like I used to be, you probably have stopped many times, but you weren't able to stay stopped. You kept going back to those behaviors. So you need to find a support to keep you from those behaviors and keep the light on in your life. So you could stop cold turkey. And let me explain to you what cold turkey means. It's not just those behaviors that you're addicted to. You're also addicted to, well, most of you are also addicted to the names of your sexual contacts in your phone. You also have those contacts when you're reaching out to them, when you feel a need to act out in your sexually addictive behavior. So not only do you need to eliminate those behaviors, you need to eliminate the phone numbers of those people that feed your addiction, your contacts, the hookups, the one-night stands. Yes, you need to eliminate those as well. Sex addiction is not an addiction that you can just dabble with. And if you're like most sex addicts that want to recover, you probably have tried so many times to stop acting out in your sex addiction, but you still have those reservations, the numbers in your phone, the pornography saved in the computer, those links that you like, your favorite porn, and their reservations. Got to get rid of the reservations. So you have to eliminate the phone numbers. You have to eliminate those apps, Grindr, and all those apps you have that feed your sex addiction. You also need to go on your computer and delete all those favorite porns that you've saved in your laptop. See, so if you want to break free from sex addiction, cold turkey, you let it all go. And you will face withdrawal if you do that, because you're withdrawing off activities that get you high, that give you a fix. And you're going to go through depression, insomnia, mood swings, anger, frustration. You're going to experience a lot of feelings going through that withdrawal. It's very difficult. That's why you need that support network. Someone or a group or a program that you can get involved in that will help you remain free from all those things you have eliminated out of your life. You're not going to be able to do it alone. You need support. Two, you can take a look at all the sexually addictive behaviors and eliminate one at a time. Eliminate one of those behaviors at a time. So you take a look at what you're addicted to. Let's just say hypothetically, you're addicted to sex clubs, dating apps and online hookups, and pornography. Well, let's eliminate one of them. Let's eliminate the sex clubs. And then in time, we'll eliminate the anonymous sex. And then in time, we'll eliminate the pornography. And your sobriety will slowly progress. The difficulty with that is, even if you're eliminating one of your sexually addicted behaviors, you're still living in your sex addiction. So it's very, very difficult to stop certain behaviors and progress when you're still getting that fix. But there have been some people that said that that worked for them. So it's sort of like an experiment. It's sort of figuring out for yourself which method will work best. Now, from my experience, my coaching program, the Sex Addicts Recovery and Transformation Accelerator Program, is cold turkey. You stop those behaviors cold turkey for 10 weeks. That's what my program is all about. 10 weeks of no sexually addictive behaviors, no connections to any of the sexually addictive people, phone numbers, apps, all of it gone for 10 weeks, cold turkey. And it's hard to do that. But I have found in my life that was what led me to the most success, is getting through the withdrawal onto the other side, where you'll experience a life free from active sex addiction, a life where you can thrive as a healthy individual. Can you imagine your life free from sex addiction? Just imagine it for a minute. If you could eliminate all the sexually addictive behaviors, all those contacts in your phone that feed your sex addiction, all of your hookups, all of the dating apps, all the pornography, all of the whatever it is you're doing in your addiction. Can you imagine eliminating all of that out of your life? Just imagine for a minute. Can you see how much available time you will have in your schedule to focus on career, a healthy relationship, social, normal, healthy social activities, building your career, and in building your career, more financial success and financial prosperity? Can you imagine what it's going to feel like every night to sleep good, to wake up fresh in the morning? Can you imagine a life where you have energy all throughout the day and you're not living in a fake fantasy world? You're not twisted-minded into the situations that you caught yourself in your sex addiction. You're living life healthy and free and laughing and having fun and hanging out with friends and building a relationship and maybe experiencing a very authentic, healthy romance. Can you just imagine a life like that? And it's possible for you because it happened to me. And if any of you know me or you know my story, over 11 years ago, I was a mess. I was methamphetamine addicted, alcohol addicted, and sex addicted. And I am sober from all those addictions over 11 years. I had to hit a hard rock bottom. I had to really fall hard. The epiphany that I had experienced is an epiphany that I believe you need if you want to experience sexual sobriety. All the decisions you make in life, pretty much all of them, are based on pain. We as humans generally make decisions based on which alternative is going to give me less pain. So for the sex addict, it feels more painful to stop all those sexually addictive behaviors. It feels so much more painful to go into the unknown than stay right where you are. So your decisions are based on pain. My epiphany came when I got arrested and I was humiliated and I was so shameful of what I was doing in my life. The pain was so great doing what I was doing that changing and transforming my life seemed so much less painful. And that's the epiphany I had. And I hope that you're at a point in your sex addiction when you're ready to experience a less painful way of life. I hope that you've experienced enough pain that got you here today, that you're willing to do whatever it takes to venture off into an unknown territory free from sex addiction that you believe is less painful now because you've been in so much pain. Are you tired of being in pain? Are you tired of being broken? Are you broken? Do you feel broken? And you just want to put the pieces of your life back together again? I make you a promise that you can put the pieces of your life back together again, but you must break free from your sex addiction. So the three alternatives I gave you today is you can remain in your sex addiction and suffer a life of loneliness and isolation and shame and guilt and wearing masks and never having a truly authentic life with integrity and dignity. Or you can break free, and there's two strategies: stop cold turkey or break down your addiction one behavior at a time and transform your life. I hope that somewhere in this short video, you received some food for thought about where you are in your sex addiction and what you want to accomplish from this moment forward. Where do you want to go? Which one of those three strategies do you want in your life? And if you want to change and transform, you must not just want it, need it, but you must be willing to do what it takes to get it. I have a 10-step strategy session that I would love you to take a look at. It's on my website. I'll have the link below. And I would love you to go and register for that 10-step strategy session. I have it a little bit in fast forward, so a lot of information in about 30 minutes. Take a pen and pencil with you. And I want you to write down what you learn in that 10-step strategy session and start using those strategies to begin breaking your active sex addiction. If I can do it, trust me, please. Trust me, you can do it too. You can live a life free. I want that for you. If you like this video and you want to see more of them, as you may know by now, I do post a new video every Tuesday on my YouTube channel. So please hit that subscribe button, hit the like button, and the bell. And I would love you to come here every Tuesday and take a look at a new video, a new lesson for you to break free from your sex addiction. You be well, have a great day. Thank you so much for being here, and you take care.